full of confidence right now, kinda. I can do this on the first try, it'd be impressive. I'm really worried about the end. But we'll see how that goes. We're gonna go with my strategy here, which is laser option, and then worry about everything else. I need at least two speed before I get to the brain. I really just need one speed on the brain, but it does help, that's for sure. But no speed on the brain. It can actually suck a little bit. Okay, double options. I'm in good shape. Let's go ahead and get those dual missiles. That part will worries me every time. Yo, I should have got the missiles already though. Would've helped me here. There we go. No, save that orange one for over here. Okay. There we go. Alright. Let me get another missile. The teeth. Fully missiled. Oh, I still need one more laser. But you don't need the double laser at this point. Got my speed. And kind of wreck shop over here right now. Can't really get that. I felt like, I kind of felt like there was a piece of the stage still there that it kind of wanted me to hit. There we go. In good shape. Parts worry me a little bit more than it should, but that's okay. Going for it, going for it. Alright, it's pretty much stage one. Unless I die from the brain, and that would be a disaster. Oh, I didn't do it on the first go around. I'm a slacker. Destroy. Destroy. All right, round two. Set of lasers. I think I've only got one speed right now. So now I've got bigger laser. Now I've got the faster laser. Got my speed. I'm straight. I don't need any. Oh, force. Almost forgot. Gotta get force. I hate when my lasers are offbeat, by the way. Like when they're not shooting at the same time, it bothers me. I don't really want that thing. I'd much rather got any power up there. Oof. Okay. I am decked out right now. I'd like you to know that my Nintendo's been acting up too, so if it freezes on me during this, I'm gonna be upset. Okay. like a sweet spot to kill these damn things. Bum 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 bum. Always forget which way I go here. Oh, I'm like fully decked out, so it's totally okay to go this way. If you try to go this way, you just got the pea shooters over for you. Always supposed to go left there though, because now I still got to deal with this one, and that is whack. And falling rocks. Stay out of the way. The thing I always liked is that, you know, you have a very different sound cue for when things cannot be broken. And I usually go this way over here. And kind of outrun this thing. A little too close. My stomach dropped a little bit right there. Still a couple spots in this game where, like, I don't know the best way to handle it, I guess I would say. Like, I know here I usually head off to this side. I think there's like one more orange dude. Yep. This game is so excellent. So you can't say there's anything wrong with this game at all. It's like perfect. And it's two players, man. Two player. And a game like this only makes it 100 times better. Wish somebody would mod Gradius 3 to be two players. That'd be awesome. Destroy. 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 Alright. I always thought it was cool here how they dropped out the score so that you can see, like, you know, more of the screen. Which I didn't actually realize until the last time I played it, which was a couple days ago. Can't believe I didn't kill it! Gotta be like literally one. I'm just gonna tap it, see if I kill it. Nope. Jeez, man. I think I had more health than I thought. And here comes the problem. Level 3. This level is an absolute nightmare. And it's not that hard by hard game standards, but it is pretty tricky. Like, you literally have to be on your toes the whole time you play this level. At least once you get inside the fire flames. There's so much you gotta pay attention to in here. And you know why I'm mad too? Like, the first time I turned this game on, again, you know, like, not the first time I ever played it, but first time I turned this game on again from not playing for a long time, I actually got all the way to the end and died on, like, the clamps. I'll call them the clamps. The barriers or whatever. The bruise. I got all the way down. I got all the way there without losing a single life. And then, oh my god, that was close. Option saved me. And then I died. And I haven't been able to do that again. But I'm determined now to beat this game without losing a single life. I've done it with Contra. I feel like this game's harder than Contra. By like a long shot. Especially this part, man. This part's so tough. Stuff comes from behind. You have to pay attention to when those things are going to pop. And sometimes they just keep going. You have the birds that you want to shoot, but you shouldn't because they'll turn into missiles and fly right towards you. And you have these things that literally constantly spawn. Like this guy, look at that. You have to know where those... I'm not doing this the right way, you know. I'm not doing it, oh my god. The option saved me. Oh my god. Okay, I'm going to slow down. I'm going to stop talking. Okay, I can talk now. So, hey, I haven't been on duty yet, and, man, that was so close. Options were saving me left and right there. So, I haven't been able to get there again and do it. And I think now's the time. I love this boss. He looks so cool. I'm not really ready for this right now because that was way too close. That was really close. I don't think I'm ready to beat this game without dying right now, but I'm gonna go for it anyway. It's so much fun to play, it doesn't really matter. These things clearly cannot be killed. Too close, too close. The ones that move real erratic and shoot at you can be killed, though. The game lets you know immediately, though you can't kill it. As soon as you hear that sound, you can't kill it. That one, those ones will die. Oh yeah, I forgot, this part's awesome. Gotta fly high speed through the brain. Actually can't beat the high speed part on Gradius 3. I think it's after the stage with like the Stonehenge guys. I've never beaten it, and I've tried it quite a few times, but I always just get caught up and super dead. Oh, the polyps! We have to kill the polyps. Are we in the brain? That's like the intestines. I forgot. It's like the intestinal level. Flying up through the intestines right now. These are clearly polyps inside of them that we want to stop from exploding. We are doing the giant monster a favor by destroying his polyps inside of his butt. And this one I let explode because I don't want to risk going in there. Then we have the gates of nerve endings. Nerve ending gates. We have the big nerve ending gates coming. And another big one. Chicken nuggets. Clearly this thing had some dinner. Yeah, the chicken nugget part can be kind of tough with the pea shooter. Thank God I got this firepower. Because those things come back. Like, when they spread out like that, they actually come back. I guess you have more room than you think. But not like like on that part where there is two of them side by side. It's tough. Polyps to chicken nuggets, spinal cord time, or is there something else before that? It's maybe my least favorite level. I do like the boss, but this part when we were kids, man, this part was so tough because you like it seemed like impossible to dodge all these things, and you were worrying about the lasers, which really can't hit you. As long as you stay where you're supposed to be at. You know, your spinal cord and ribcage does that in real life if you were to actually look in there. They shoot lasers. See, now this part is real tricky, like, again, without this kind of weapon. Because you'll be there for a while trying to shoot that thing in the face. This is where I died last time. I died this level. I died on the obstacle part with the poles going up and down. Making pretty good progress. That part with the poles just gives me anxiety, man. It's so much tougher than I remember. There's just like one spot that's tricky, and that's I died just because I got nervous. The blueberries. Space blueberries. We have came outside of the head of the giant monster, and now we are flying in between space blueberries. On a distant planet or asteroid. Oh, alright. Little blue guys start coming. Alien life forms. I mean, I guess that's what those guys are, right? Like, we're on distant planet, like, these things are being piloted. These aren't just robots. These things are clearly being piloted by some form of shit, you know, alien. They don't want me here on their planet. I love how they throw so many guys at you and the game just gets completely destroyed. Time to go inside. Oh no, the damn ceiling falls for a little while. There's another part that was a little bit tougher when I was a kid than I remembered. Okay, alright, I almost died there. I held it together. Nerves, man. You're nervous when you're going for it, like, are way worse than if I was just turned on the game and played it and did really well. I turn on the game, play it, beat the game without dying. But then when I'm trying to go for and record it, it's just like, man, you get really nervous. Same thing in like a tournament, I guess. Same type of things. Really wish I knew what I was worshiping in here. Come on, option. Kill it. Kill it. That was close. This is where I died, right here. Let's not die this time. Let's pay attention. Nothing slick. It's this one. Okay. Okay. Nerves are shot. My nerves are shot after that. I'm like, my heart's pounding. I don't know why it's such a damn trouble spot, but it's like just tricky to look at, you know? This too. I shouldn't be worrying about it. But I guess, you know, your average person who hadn't played before might be dying there, you know what I'm saying? Don't really know if there's a particularly best way to handle this part, but I'll just go this way. Clearly it wasn't this way, or else I wouldn't have had to drop down. Okay. Missiles getting the job done over here. That level's more stressful than it's supposed to be. It really is. It's like, man, stomach's dropping over here. I love that how the thing looks like really, like, looks like a man. It's like a, looks, I guess I don't really know what the word is, but it looks more vicious until it opens, and it opens, it's got like the pretty pharaoh face, but there it looks all manly and evil. Let's go. I thought it was funny how that thing automatically gets the first shot. Like the bosses in this game, bosses get first shot. Alright, there we go. And last level, here we come. Stay calm. Soon the shitstorm will be upon us. A little bit of a stressful area. You can get trapped. This part. Keep shooting just to slow the game down, pretty much. Does help a little. Close. He almost had me there. Hang on front. Never understood what these fire things are supposed to be or where they're coming from or what. Am I flying above a city right now and they're like shooting up at me? It's weird. Okay. Getting a little nervous now. Apologize for not being so active on the mic, but I am really nervous. I always love these things in these games. I don't know why. I just thought they were, they look so cool. And I always shoot the rings, for whatever reason. I hate how they go through the walls, though. Here we go. So much health on that guy, huh? Game doesn't take that long to beat, but you don't want to have to do it all over again. Oh boy, here we go. Heart, my chest is pounding. You can probably physically see me shaking just from my heart beating so hard. I think that's it, guys. Hooray for me. That makes me very happy that I was able to do that. Oh, I'm so nervous. Thank you, Konami, for producing such an awesome game. I'm very excited to have beaten yet another one of your games without losing. Hopefully you and Hideo Kojima will be friends again, and you guys won't release games that aren't finished. Clearly this game is finished. Metal Gear Solid 5 was not finished. It was great. But I do wish I got to fight Sahelanthropus again. Anyway, this is my letter to you, Konami. After I've destroyed one of your games, even though it almost killed me a couple times. Thank you very much.